absolutely. One of my favorite maps from Call of Duty Ghosts was Warhawk. I loved the fact that it was a smaller map out of all of the larger maps that existed in that game. And now it's back in the form of Heartland for DLC 4 in Call of Duty Infinite Warfare. I want to send a thank you to Activision. I wasn't able to go to the event, but they did send me this early gameplay, and it gives us a very good look on what this map is like. Now, if you remember Warhawk, then you're going to be very comfortable in how to navigate this map. I was pretty surprised that they pretty much kept everything intact exactly how it was. There really isn't too much of a difference. The only change here is the fact that we don't have destructible walls like we had in Ghosts, and you don't need to shoot the gate open. It's automatically open for you. The map layout is exactly the same though. Some cases it's a little different, like over where the tool shop is. Instead of having that one gated side where everyone would head glitch the gate, it's now a huge open area with actually no barricades, which is kind of strange, but I guess that kind of makes sense for the futuristic movement. Obviously, there's going to be more open areas and wall running opportunities. That was the biggest fear I had for this particular map. I didn't actually want it to be wall running city. I wanted it to have the same kind of flow and play style that it had with Call of Duty Ghosts. I know that's a little bit difficult to do in a game with futuristic movement, but based off of all the footage that I've seen so far, and of course the footage you're watching right now, pretty much anybody that takes the opportunity to wall run, they're putting themselves in a risk versus reward situation. They're risking it because you're out in the open, you're up above the ground, and obviously people are going to see you, but the reward could be heavy if you take somebody off guard, and of course you can just wipe out the enemy team if they're playing on the B flag or whatever the case may be. Flag locations, bomb locations, everything like we used to see in Ghosts, they are all intact and exactly where they were in that game. But now in Infinite Warfare. One of my favorite features in Call of Duty Ghosts was the field order. If you guys don't remember, you were able to earn a field order in the multiplayer. The field order can be completed by doing a challenge like knifing an enemy or teabagging an enemy, humiliating them, and you would earn a care package. Throwing down that care package would grant you any of the streaks in the game or a secret streak specifically made for specific maps. Warhawk in this instance had a secret streak called the mortar fire, which it would just rain mortar strikes from above, and it would like annihilate people that were caught out in the open. I was really hoping they would do something like that as a throwback on this particular map, but from the looks of this gameplay, I don't see anything like a field order. I don't know if maybe if you call it a deatomizer strike, it would act a little bit differently, or maybe you would get a mortar fire in some way, shape, or form. Maybe they added it to a care package and it's actually a secret streak, but nobody at the recording event actually ended up getting it. So we'll have to try to like play around in private matches with care packages and stuff and see if we can end up getting a secret streak or maybe the mortar fire or whatever. But like I said, this map layout is literally exactly the same. Even some of the stuff looks similar, like garbage cans and of course vehicle placements. You even have the tarp over by the radio antenna. So that's exactly the same like we normally had in Call of Duty Ghosts. I will say in some places it looks a little wider on this map, like it was artificially widened, but then again, it could be that there's just less stuff cramping the map, because in COD Ghosts, I remember there was just a lot more stuff, if that makes any sense, like in the center especially, where the crater is and where the B flag location is, but overall I think that this is a really good representation of what was going on in COD Ghosts, and I think that for right now, based on the gameplay I see and of course everything I've been hearing from the recording event, it is a fan favorite map, and I think it's probably going to be one of my favorites in DLC 4 as well. So I'd really like to know what you guys think down below in the comments section. Are you excited to play this map? I'd really like to know. If you guys enjoyed the video here today, do not forget to take a moment of your time to click that like button down below. If you would like to as well, don't forget to subscribe for more videos coming each and every day. And if you're already subscribed, don't forget to click that notification button. Stay up to date on when I upload each and every day. Thank you guys so much for the continued support, and I'll see you tomorrow. Peace.